हेलो, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. माय डियर स्टूडेंट, वी हैड डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो रेडियो एक्टिविटी, एटेन्यूएशन, टाइप्स ऑफ रेडिएशन अंडर द टाइप ऑफ रेडिएशन आयनाइजिंग इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन लाइक एक्सरेज, गामा रेज, फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट एंड कैप्सन इफेक्ट्स, पेयर प्रोडक्शन, थॉमसन स्कैटरिंग एंड ब्रैक्स लॉ. वी हैड डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो इन विच ब्रैक्स लॉ इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लॉ. सो सम न्यूमेरिकल क्वेश्चंस आस्क्ड ऑन द ब्रैक्स लॉ वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. So come to the point, and the next topic is principle of gamma radiography and radiation source, which is the very important topic which is related to the non-destructive testing. So come to the point, the first one is the radiation source. So these are the classified under two categories. First one is a natural radioactive source and second one is a man-made radioactive source. My dear student, I have already sent the notes of unit 3. So you have the notes and then follow this video. So you should better understand. So first point is the natural radioactive source. What is natural radioactive sources? The two elements which have been widely used in industrial radiography are radium and mesothorium. The natural radioactives are radium and mesothorium. These two materials are basically used in the radiography. So that is the natural radioactive sources and many other elements which is used in the natural radioactive sources. And the second one is the man-made radioactive source. What is man-made radioactive sources? These sources are obtained by irradiation in a nuclear reactor. When an extra neutron is added to the nucleus of atom, neutron gets deflected and energy is released in the form of gamma rays. It's mean if the source are obtained irradiation in a nuclear reactor, some neutrons gets deflected from the atoms and get released some energy in the form of gamma rays. This example, selenium 75 and the cobalt 60, these are the example of radioactive sources which is made by man, right? And thus if the man-made product, every product having some advantage and some disadvantage. So there are some advantages of man-made radioactive sources. So first advantage is can work without electric supply. It is very good for the industries. Okay, if electricity is not required, then we save the money. The first point is can work without electric supply, and the second one is available in various shape and size, a higher radiation hardness than the X-ray. But also some disadvantages are energy level cannot be controlled, okay, radiation intensity cannot be controlled, okay, limited service life and produce less contrast. So every product, every element having some advantage and disadvantage. So these are the advantage and disadvantage of man-made radioactive sources. Now we move to advantage of gamma rays over X-rays radiography. So my dear student, this topic is important the for semester point of view. So please concentrate on these points and also focus in your study notes. The first point is X-ray have lower penetrating intensity than gamma ray. Everybody knows that the X-ray have a lower penetrating intensity because gamma rays are mostly used in industries for the penetration. Gamma rays are also used in the welding process and machining process. So gamma rays have the higher penetrating intensity as compared to X-rays. So we already know that. The second point is scattering in gamma rays is very less comparison to X-rays. It is very important. Scattering or spreading scattering in gamma rays is very less comparison to X-rays. Okay, third point is gamma rays are preferred in industrial radiography, where X-ray is preferred in medical radiography. My dear student, you know that the X-ray is basically used in the medical field, X-ray of full body, X-ray of the chest, X-ray of the everything. It's related to the human body. So basically, X-ray is used in the medical field, but gamma rays are basically used in the industrial radiography because the penetrating rays which is produced from the gamma is very high. That's why gamma rays are used in the industry and X-ray is used in the medical radiography. So keep in mind. The fourth point is in gamma rays, radiography sensitivity is very high. And the fifth point is the source of gamma rays are cheap and are available in the nature. And the sixth point is certain distance penetration, gamma rays decay itself by losing it all energy. Equipment of gamma rays are portable and safe. So safety is very important point of view, very important for the human worker, if you're operator of the system. So safety is very important and portable is the very important part. So these are the points which is related to the gamma rays and X-rays, the advantage of gamma rays over X-rays. So my dear student, keep in mind these points are very important to learn it. This next topic is scattered radiation. So what is scattered radiation? So when X-rays or gamma rays passes through any object, it's mean X-ray or gamma, we have X-ray or gamma rays, and when the gamma rays or X-rays is passing through any object, any material, it gets attenuation upon the uniformity of the object. If object is uniformly, then attenuation will be uniform and radiation image will be eventually exposed of the object is non-uniform or it contains any defect. The attenuation will be non-uniform and radiation image will be unevenly exposed, resulting and shadow image of the object and defect in it. Scatter radiation means when we have X-ray or gamma rays, and gamma rays or X-rays passes through any object, then attenuation. What is attenuation? We have already discussed in the previous video. Attenuation. Attenuation. It's mean reduce the radiation of the rays. Reduce the intensity of the rays. That is attenuation. So if gamma rays or X-rays are passing through any object, so definitely some intensity of the rays are decreased or reduced. So that is the scattered radiation. When radiation is focused on any object, some part of radiation is transmitted through the object and form the image, and some get scattered continuously in the non-forming of image. Means if the X-rays or gamma rays are focusing on the object, then some part of radiation is transmitted through the object. That object on which the gamma rays or alpha gamma rays or gamma rays or X-rays are incident, and some of the rays are scattered non-forming image. So that is the scattered radiation. And here the scattered radiation factor, what is scattering factor, is equals to, actually scattering factor is equals to RT upon RS, where RT is equals to transmitting radiation and RS is equals to scattered radiation. It is the ratio of transmitted to scattered radiation. It's mean total radiation is equals to the summation of our transmitted radiation and the scattered radiation. So I hope ki scattering radiation samajh mein aa gaya hoga. So now move to the next topic, that is the X-ray film. So we have studied about the X-ray film. It is a medium that record the image of object exposed to X-ray. An X-ray film has total thickness 0.5 mm approximately and is made of 7 layer as shown in the figure. To come to the figure here, here the 0.5 mm thicks. It's mean the X-ray film approximately the thickness of the X-ray film is 0.5 mm and there are some layers. The first above layer is the protecting layer. We focus, we see the full figure. The first on the top protecting layer, and the just near below the protecting layer is the emulsion layer, and just below the bonding layer, and then base layer, and then bonding layer, and then emulsion layer, and the protecting layer. So my dear student, this is the X-ray film. the thickness of X-ray film is 0.5 mm, and these are the several layers which is involved with the X-ray film. So X-ray film, so now types of the X-ray film. There are the following types of the X-ray films which is involved with the X-ray, and basically X-ray are basically used in the non-destructive testing. It is very useful. So first is on the basis of the photo sensitive emulsion layer. Under this photosensitive emulsion layer, the first one is a single bond and second one is the double bond, and the second is on the basis of intensifying screens, the screen films and non-screen film. There are two types of film, screen films and non-screen film. And the third one is on the basis of type of emulsion coating. Then there are three types. First one is a blue light sensitive film, and second green and red. And these are the three types of X-ray. And the next, on the basis of film speed. So under the film speed, it is categorized in the three parts. First one is a standard speed film, and the second one is a fast speed film, and the third one is the ultra fast speed. So my dear student, these are the types of the X-ray film. Now come to the next point topic, that is the film interpretation. It refers to the evaluation of quality of the radiography image. For this, the film is placed in front of an illuminated screen of the proper brightness. It's mean, if you want the clarity in film, in photos, so we have used the film interpretation, which is placed in front of the illumination screen, then we have for the proper brightness. Due to the brightness, proper brightness, the photos or images will be clear. So film interpretation is used for this particular purpose. And the factor of required for interpretation of film, what are the factor required for the interpretation of film if you want to use? The first one is density of radiography image. What is the density of the radiography image? And the second is the luminous of a screen, what is the brightness and the luminous of the screen. And the third is the eyesight is also important. The last, lighting condition of the room. These are the important factor which is required for the interpretation of film. With the help of film interpretation, they are produced the good quality of images, which is very beneficial in the medical field. The next topic is the radiographic sensitivity. It is defined in terms of quality of radiography images of detection of the smallest image. Radio sensitivity depends on two variables, contrast of radiography image and definition of radiography images. My dear student, it is defined in terms of quality of radiography image. Basically, radiography sensitivity is defined as the quality of the image which is detected by the radiography sensitivity. Next topic is the radiographic contrast. It refers to the degree of difference in density between two mass of the radiography image. It helps in define the different defects from the surrounding. It's when radio contrast basically used for the find out the defect of the images. So we have understand what is the radiography sensitivity and radiographic contrast. Both are the used for the find out the defect in the film which is produced from the film interpretation. So my dear student, I hope aapko cheeze samajh mein aa rahi hogi. And the next topic is radiographic definition. It refers to the apparatus of change density. It has two main factors, geometric factors and film factors, right? So radiographic definition is also here. So and radiographic density, it is the measure of degree of darkness of the film. If anybody asks to you what is radiography density, it is the measure of degree of darkness of film. It is called radiography density. My dear student, it is very important for 1 marks, 2 marks. What is radiographic density? It is the measure of the degree of darkness of the film, that is known as the radiographic density. And here is the formula, mathematical formula of the radiography density is equals to log I naught upon IT, where I naught is the incident radiation on the film, what are the rays coming from the X-ray or gamma rays which is incident on the film, that is I naught, incident of radiation that is indicated by the I naught, and the IT is equals to transmitted radiation through the film. If any rays incident on some object or some film, then definitely some rays are transmitted. That is IT. So for keep in mind, the formula of radiography density is log is equals to log I naught upon IT. My dear student, this is the radiography density. And thank you for watching. If you have any doubt or if you have any problem in any topic related to any topic, feel free to ask through the mail, through the WhatsApp number, through our comment below the video, and personally call to me. If you have any genuine problem. So my dear student, thanks for the watching, and the next video is coming very soon, and we will discuss in the further lecture of the some numerical on the Bragg's law, and how to find out the Bragg's law and how to find out the interplanar distance. So keep watching, keep in touch. Thanks for the watching.